Treat yourself to a little something organic. Cora's whisper-thin yet mighty absorbent pads have a breathable 100% organic cotton top sheet and are made without fragrance, dyes, and chlorine. Because your vulva's not a hot tub. With patented smart channels for up to 8 hours of leak protection, Cora's got you covered however you flow. Plus, Cora donates period products to people in need with every purchase. Find Cora nationwide at Target, CVS, and online at cora.life.
Speed Gibson of the International Secret Police.
After Speed, Clint, and Smiley, with the aid of Mr. Philippa, capture two octopus gangsters in the Whispering Cave on Madeira, they're about to leave when the octopus boat arrives to pick up the two criminals. Clint forces one, Dixon, to signal the boat to pick them up that night in Regis Cove. But suspecting that all is not as it should be, and recognizing Speed as the youngest member of the secret police, the outlaw boat launches a dinghy filled with armed men. The boys, forced back to the mouth of the cave, prepare to hold them off. But when a gun is uncovered on the deck of the octopus boat, rather than be blown off the beach, Clint orders everyone back into the cave. We find the party now trying to beat the fast rising tide, which is lapping their ankles.
Mm-hmm. We sure got ourselves in a nice hole, Clint. Do you think we're ever going to get out of this alive?
There's a better chance of it in here. And yet we'd have stayed on the beach, Smiley. Hurry up a little, will you? This tide's running in fast.
Yeah, I know.
You think the octopus gangsters will try to follow us in here, Clint?
I don't think so, Speed. They'll know that we'll be ready for that. I imagine they'll wait until low tide and then try to surprise us. Don't you, Philippa?
Yes, Mr. Barlow. It is not a happy outlook.
Yeah.
Those emergency rations and the canteens of fresh water will not last forever. Starvation is the ally of those of criminals.
Don't worry about that. While there's life, there's hope.
At least we're out of the water.
Yes, we'll reach the tide line soon. Once above that, we can stop and catch our breath. It hasn't been easy hurrying like this. Carrying supplies and weapons?
Yeah. But boy, this is sure some cave. I'd like to explore sometime when the octopus gang isn't after us.
You'll probably see a whole lot more of this here cave than you want before you get out of here, boy. I have already, and this is only the beginning.
All right. Here's the mark of the tide. Now then, take a little easier. You know we're safe in the water, at least.
Unless a tidal wave pops in. Would we be embarrassed?
Hey, Dixon. Did you leave any supplies in that room you occupied in here?
There might be some stuff. I don't know.
A room, Clint?
Sort of a natural rock room, Speed. A shortwave sending and receiving set in there. Oh, say, Speed, I've got some bad news for you.
What?
The octopus is alive. We heard his voice coming in over the shortwave set talking to Dixon here.
The octopus? Alive? I might have known it. He did use a parachute after falling through that cloud bank. But even then, Clint, how'd he ever get out of the Himalayas alive?
I hope we can ask him that question personally someday. But now, at least, we definitely know what we're up against. And that somehow he's connected with the Atlantean Syndicate. So what do you know about that, Dixon?
Atlantean Syndicate? What are you talking about?
Oh, you're going to play dumb, huh?
No, but I don't know what he's talking about. I was just hired to bump off a guy wearing a hat and coat, which was described in detail. It turns out that Barlow ain't wearing that hat and coat, so I kills an innocent guy. But I don't know anything about this Atlantean hooey.
And you have admitted the murder. You should have paid the penalty.
Don't make me laugh, Tin Soldier. Where did you get out of here with your skin before you start telling me what penalty I'll have to pay?
What about this other fella, Clint?
Well, he either can't or won't talk. He hasn't said a word since this all began.
But he packs a mean punch.
Did he hit you in that fight, Smiley?
Of course. Didn't you know I'm the punching bag of this outfit? Or didn't you know?
Oh, come on. Let's go into Dixon's hideaway and see what else we can find beside that shortwave set.
Clint!
Huh?
Why can't we send an SOS over that shortwave set?
Philippa, have the police shortwave equipment in their offices?
No, Mr. Barlow, but there are several amateur stations on the island.
Well, one of them might pick up our call for help.
It's worth the try.
Why didn't we think of that before?
Speed, you're great.
Ah, you're all crazy. You can't use that set. It's ultra-shortwave. Nothing on this island could pick it up.
There is a chance. One station in particular is experimenting in ultra-shortwave.
Well, come on. Let's get into that room and see what can be done. Wait a minute.
Huh?
All be quiet. I want to see if the landing party has entered the cave or not.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess we're safe for the time being.
Yeah, all I can hear is water. Too much of it suit me.
Well, listen while you can, Smiley. When we're out in the Sahara Desert looking for the Atlantean expedition, maybe we'll wish we were back here.
Wash your mouth, will you? This is bad enough without dragging the desert in, too.
All right. Break it up. Let's go into that rock room.
Well, bless my grandpa's whiskers. Look at all the stuff in this room.
All right, look the place over. While I get on this short wave set, Smiley. Find out exactly what we can count on in here.
I wouldn't count on anything in here, personal.
You help him, Speed. And Mr. Philippa, I'll count on you to keep our prisoners quiet.
You may depend on me, Mr. Barlow.
Boy, I sure hope Clint can get word to someone who might help us.
You said it, boy. You know, Speed, most anything could happen to us in here and nobody'd be the wiser. I don't know if it was smart or not to come in here.
We had to, Smiley.
Yeah, six one way, half a dozen the other. Oh, well, we're in. Let's see what we can find in here that might help us. What's in this box? Empty.
Hey, listen, I'm thirsty. Can I have a drink?
Yes, Dixon, you may have a drink, but not too much.
Yeah, go easy with that canteen. We've only got two for the lot of us.
Don't worry, I'll go easy.
Here you are.
Thanks.
Look out, he's going to throw the canteen. Let me out, I'll try and save some of that water.
Gosh, why'd you do that, Dixon? If we run out of water before we get out of here, you'll be just as thirsty as the rest of us.
What do I got to lose? Whether I croak from thirst in here from a rope around my neck outside, it's all the same.
Keep that other canteen out of his reach.
Yes, certainly I will.
Doggone you, Razorback. I'll skin you alive for doing that. I couldn't save a drop of water.
All right, take it easy, Smiley. I don't think we'll need water anyway. Well, I think I've got the set ready for the broadcast.
Yeah, Clint? Swell.
We'll try her anyhow. Keep your fingers crossed and pray that somebody picks us up.
All right.
Calling Madeira stations. Calling all Madeira stations. This is Clint Barlow of the International Secret Police. We're trapped in Whispering Cave. We're trapped in Whispering Cave by a desperate band of criminals. Their boat is in the bay. Come armed and come immediately. Any amateur picking up this message, please relay to Madeira Police at once.
Boy, they ought to get something.
I'll wait a few seconds, then give that call again.
Listen, the octopus.
Do you reckon he heard Clint? If he did, we're some.
So, Clint Barlow, you are still alive.
Yes, and I intend to remain so.
And yet you send out a call for help.
Crawl back into your hole, Octopus. You may be alive, but you can't stop us from escaping now.
Oh, can't I?
Sounds like he thinks he can.
Yes, you fools. I barely caught your call for help, so I could not stop it. But I can destroy you before any help could reach you.
You're bluffing, Octopus. Nothing you can say or do will stop us from catching up with you this time. And when we do, you'll not escape.
We shall see, Barlow. Meantime, listen to the voice of the octopus. And see if you will be able to reply.
Now, what do you mean by that?
I don't know. But it's useless to send out a call again. He'll have found a way to blot us off the air.
Gosh, I sure hope somebody heard that first one, Clint. But what do you mean, listen to the voice of the octopus?
I don't know.
Listen, what can it be?
Thunder!
No,
it's the gun on the octopus ship. They're shelling this cave. We're caught in our own trap.